Hi, this is Alexis Thibault and welcome to episode 3 of Making Music in Shadertoy. Last time we had a look at frequency modulation synthesis and we created a couple of instruments using it. We saw how it is a convenient tool to create some instruments, and today I would like to complete our tool set of instruments. So we were creating a song with 100 BPM. I would like to add a bass to it, add a marimba and another synth. So the marimba, we will be doing it using frequency modulation synthesis as well. It happens to be a kind of a classic sound with in frequency modulation. And for the bass and the other synth, we will be doing it them using filtered sawtooth wave in order to have that kind of 80s, very, very cool 80s bass sound, very plucky. It's kind of trendy right now. So yeah, let's get into it. So last time we were doing some frequency modulation. We created a pad which was playing some chords and it had some pattern. I slightly modified the reverb this time. So yeah, it's playing slightly differently. The lead synth I didn't touch since last time. So it was playing with the vibrato and it had several elements and some fake compression to it. And it was playing a kind of complicated pattern for which we had to define this this macro. So yeah, let's right away, let's look at the bass. Let's start with the marimba. The marimba is kind of a classic frequency modulation. It's a classic frequency modulation sound. How you create it is actually very simple. So you have you want to play a marimba note at frequency F, and with some time t. So t here is as in every one of the synth I create, t is the time since the start of the note. So we do some frequency modulation with carrier frequency. If you remember, the formula for frequency modulation is right here. So we have a carrier frequency, a modulator frequency, and an index of modulation. And we do sine of 2 pi times, basically fc times t. I'm using a fract here to avoid problems with precision in the sine function. So 2 pi times fc times t would be just a sine wave at frequency fc, the carrier frequency, and then we add index of modulation times a sine wave at frequency fm. Here what do we use as fm and as a carrier frequency? We put just f, and the modulator frequency we put a high frequency. If you remember last time, we saw that the frequency modulation signal contains frequency at fc plus and minus multiples of fm. So here it will be f plus and minus multiples of 7 times f. So the first one will actually be f plus 7f, so 8 times f, and f minus 7f, so negative 6, which will just be turned to the positive side, so plus 6 times f. So we get very frequencies spread very far apart, and it turns out that it actually sounds kind of like a woody instrument. Marimba is kind of like a xylophone. Now, to the index of modulation, you notice that I've put something that starts at 1.5 and then decays very rapidly to zero. So only at the very start of the note do we get these high harmonics, and then very, very fast we get only the sinusoidal component. That also mirrors how the physics of the instrument works. It's an instrument which plays some very, very weird kind of dissonant harmonics when it is struck, but very fast those harmonics decay and you get only the fundamental frequency. So that's the idea with it. And then we put some decay on it, a simple exponential decay. So if we listen to the marimba by itself, it's going to sound like this. Sig plus equal marimba, let's say at 440, and let's have it play every second. Here it is. So as you hear, it really has that woody quality to it. If you want to change the sound of it, you can change the how fast the envelopes decay. So we can put a slower decay on the index of modulation. And now we're getting a more glassy sound. It feels like the material is heavier or more more rigid. We could change the modulation frequency. Here we're getting something that's similar to a classic FM patch called EP1, electric piano. If you have the possibility to download some and play with some emulation of the DX7 Yamaha synth, it's a really fantastic tool to learn about all this frequency modulation stuff. There's the Dext VST, which is a free VST, which emulates the Yamaha DX7, and it's really a fantastic tool. I will put a link in the description for it. But I like the sound as it is, so let's just leave it like that. Now, how do we create a pattern with it? Here I've created a pattern. What I would like to do is have the marimba play kind of a techno pattern. So one thing we can do is, so let's say we have 16 beats, so 4-bar pattern that repeats, and then we choose a couple of notes, and those notes will happen to be in the same chords as the pad. So if you remember, the pad was playing some chords right here. Let me comment them so we remember what those chords are. It was A minor, then D minor 7, then F major, then C with a 9th, and then G with a 6th. So what the marimba can play here are some notes that come from this pattern. So here, just like before, all the notes are referenced relative to middle C. So 4 is going to mean 4 semitones above middle C, so that's an E. 12 is going to mean 1 octave above middle C, so that's C 1 octave higher. And similarly, so this is E and C, this is F and A, here is A and C, G and C, G and B. That's the pattern we're playing. I'm offsetting the start of those chords a bit, just so that it falls with the restart of a note. So how do I decide which time to restart a note? Well, I'm doing some mod things here, just having some fun. the most important one is this one. The idea is really to play some dotted eighth notes. This is a classic pattern in techno and that kind of a music or electro or stuff like that. It's when you have the pulse going like that, and you have something that goes dum 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 dum, you know. So you get kind of a polyrhythmic feel. The other ones are just to make sure this pattern falls onto the grid, and we don't get anything out of place. Then I define a signal and I add this marimba note. I have a little bit more of the low note than the high note. The low note is more to the left and the high note is more to the right, and I just return that. So let's actually have a listen to what that pattern sounds like. Let me leave this out for the moment. That's the pulse. So yeah, it's kind of really really techno sound. What we can do is add the pad on top of it to hear how they fit together. So yeah, that's it. So that's it for the marimba pattern. There's really nothing more to it than that. So let's move on to the bass. For the bass, I wanted to do some analog feeling sound. So last time we saw that on the first episode we saw that it's a pretty bad idea to create a sawtooth wave directly, because it contains so much high frequency that it's doing some aliasing, and that aliasing tends to sound pretty bad. How do we deal with aliasing? Well, we do anti-aliasing. So how do we do anti-aliasing? The idea is filtering. Let me create in Graphtoy the waveform we had last time as our sawtooth wave. Here it is. So we say the value of the sawtooth wave, it starts at 1, and then as x goes from 0 to 1, it has a slope of minus 2 times x, so that when x gets close to 1, it gets close to minus 1. And then it repeats. But the problem with that is that we have a huge discontinuity at x equals 0, x equals 1, etc. That's a bad idea. So we want to smooth that discontinuity. How can we do that? Well, what we can do is we have a linear, well, a fine function here. We have another linear part here. Let's decide that from about here to about here, we will smoothly transition from one to another. So we will do mix of, so this one is minus 1 minus 2 times x, and this one is 1 minus 2 times x. And how do we transition from one to another? Well, we do a smooth step function, which goes from 0, when x equals minus 0.2 up to 1 when x equals 0.2. And that is how we transition from the first part to the second. Now, how do we make sure that this repeats? No, right now it's going off to infinity. We don't want that. How do we make it repeat? We just simply clip, well, not clip, repeat. Repeat it. So if we do x minus round x, that means we cut it at negative 0.5 and positive 0.5, and we just repeat it like that. So that's it, really. That's our filtered sawtooth function. There are some much better ways to do it. This one is pretty simple, really easy to understand. If we want to change what the cutoff frequency is, we can change how wide this smooth step is, so we can have more high frequencies by doing a shorter smooth step. Maybe a better way to do it, if you're into like analog filters, would be to have a look at some second order low pass filters and things like that. It turns out that it's really not convenient to implement in Shadertoy. You really can't. What you really have to do is take paper and derive the function yourself. So I did it actually. At some point, I had a look at how a second order filter reacts to a sawtooth function, and the solution is a pretty complicated function. So I will put the link in the description if you want to have a look at it. The nice thing with it is that you can have some resonance if you're into more acid-like sounds. That's a fun thing that you can use. We get that kind of sound. So it tends to be pretty rich, but I find that this one is it's simpler and it's very, very convenient as well. So that's what I chose to use for this tutorial. So let's define a filtered saw function. We would like it to play some frequency F, to have a certain cutoff frequency, and to play at a certain time t. So what corresponds to the parameter x in our graph here? Well, x is just f times t. We want something to be a 1 over f periodic here, so we want a wave that is x periodic now. And what will be the width of our smooth step function? Well, we need what we would like to have is, if t goes up by 1 over fc, then we want, like, from this point to be 1 over fc, except that we've scaled the x-axis, so we actually want it to be f over fc, and then we multiply that by 1/2, because we have the negative part and the positive part. We absolutely don't want the width to get greater than 1/2, otherwise we will get something that looks really bad. Let me show you how that looks. Yeah, if we do the smooth step for too long, once we get into the rounding, we actually reintroduce some discontinuities, so we really don't want the width to go beyond 1/2. And then we do, as we said, x minus equals round x, and we mix between the first one and the second one using a smooth step. Now we can use it, we can use this waveform to create a bass synth. What I wanted to do was to have a really 80s-ish sound. So I wanted to use some filtered sawtooth functions. Here is just the carrier. Let me play the bass synth pattern by itself. So what is going on here? We have chosen a certain frequency, and then how do we choose the cutoff frequency? The cutoff frequency is a very fast decaying envelope. So the minimal value is 100 hertz, and then on top of that we add an envelope that goes up to 15 kilohertz, which gets close to the upper range of a human audition. The upper range is about 20 kilohertz. You really don't want anything in your signal to be above 20k, because you really won't hear it if it's there, and it might alias. So overall, don't put any frequencies beyond 20k. So here we have this decaying envelope, very fast decay. And what I did was divide F by 2 to have this kind of sub-bass frequency. The actual frequency I'm being given goes into this function here. So this goes into the left ear. What I'm doing here is some detuning. I'm using T plus 1 here just because otherwise we don't quite hear the detuning. If the waves start, all the waves start at phase equals 0, so if you want to hear the detuning, they need to start at a kind of random phase. So that's just what this plus 1 is for here. Yeah, let's hear it in stereo. That's it. Let me add the sub bass. And now we're really, really in the 80s. And I felt that it lacked a little bit of a very low sub bass. So I added just a sinusoidal fundamental frequency right here. So that's it. How did I create the pattern? Well, for the pattern, you can go and have a pattern that loops every 4 bars, just the same. And then we choose a note number based on when we are in those 4 bars. So in the first bar, we want to be playing an A. In the second bar, we want to be playing a D, then an F, then in the last bar, we want to change twice. We want to change after two beats. So the first two beats are C, and the last two beats are G. When you choose the notes for the bass, you've got to be kind of careful what the very lowest pitch you will be playing is. Let me explain that in more detail. You want the very lowest pitch to be between about 40 to 100 hertz. You don't want to play anything too high, otherwise it's not gonna sound like a strong bass, and you don't want anything too low, otherwise it's going to sound muddy. here, let me play it an octave lower, just so you hear what's a bad idea when it's playing too low. Yeah, this one is I mean, it's up to your taste, but when it's too low, you really don't get that much of the feeling. So what actually is our lowest pitch here? Well, we've got this negative 5 right here. So the negative 3 here is the A below middle C. So that's A 220. Except that we're dividing it by 2, so we're telling our synth to play at 110 hertz, except that in our signal we have the sub, which is now playing at 55 hertz. So that's exactly where we want the lowest note to be. Now with this bass, I would like to have it move a little bit more. So one way to have the bass move that is very, very often used in techno and electro, and now also very much in pop and synth pop kind of music, is to use sidechain compression. So imagine you have some drums doing very loud hits. How do you make it feel that those hits are very, very loud? Well, there's one trick that is very convenient, is if you duck all the rest of the stuff, our ears will perceive those hits as being super loud. And then when the sounds come back up, we will perceive also those sounds as being loud, just not as loud as those hits. So although we don't have any drums yet, that's what I want to do for the bass. So imagine we have a kick drum going boom, boom, boom at every beat. Then what we can do is have this kind of envelope right here. So what does this envelope, I call it pumping. It's really a fake sidechain compression. So what does it do? Well, it goes up from 0 to 1 in about 0.2 seconds at every beat. And then it goes back down at the very end of every beat. Okay. So if we apply it directly onto our bass synth pattern, you will hear that those quarter notes, eighth notes that we were playing are now the each first one is being ducked and completely inaudible. That's what it sounds like. So that's too much, obviously, but it demonstrates the idea. And now if we mix pumping with one, so that the envelope goes down only to 0.2 and then goes back up to 1. That's what we get. So we get some dynamics in our sound, and we can add the pad chord pattern as well, and also do some fake sidechain compression on it, although we will be doing a bit less on it. And same thing for the marimba, and we only do a tiny bit of sidechain compression on the marimba. So now we're really getting that is something that is quite musical, I think. Let's move on to the last instrument I wanted to add in this episode. I called it a wah-lead. It's just a synth that goes, there's something, some little interventions now and then. It goes whop, 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 that kind of idea. So I want this synth to have a short duration. So I used 0.1 here, but that's just to have something easy to change. And I created a first envelope that goes from 0 to 1 in dur over 2, and then from 1 back down to 0 in dur over 2. This envelope I used in the cutoff frequency of my fake filtered sawtooth function. I say it's fake. It's actually a real filter. It's not. It's just not really a traditional filter in the usual sense. What's called a finite impulse response filter. Anyway, the second envelope I decided should modulate the amplitude of our synth. So I wanted the amplitude to go up quickly and then go back down a little more slowly. The cutoff frequency, I wanted it to be not too low at the start. So 400 Hertz is fairly medium, and then go up by only about 10 kilohertz. So not all the way up to the extremes of the hearing range. I just wanted it to open up quite a bit, but not being too bright either. And then it's just a matter of creating this filtered saw function. Then the pattern, this pattern is just weird. So it's repeating every four bars. We are choosing a note that just fits in. It's just really the same as before. Here we're choosing to play an E and then an F and then an F and then an E and then a D. So that those notes fit within the chords that we are playing, and they kind of complete with the other instruments, so they don't clash too much. And then this stuff here, I really can't explain it. It was all about playing with the duration of the note. It's all about restarting the note every now and then to have an interesting pattern of notes that kind of start and then go. Let me play it for you. Here it is. Let's leave out the fake sidechain for now. So yeah, so these fast repeating notes are due to this kind of thing here, and then the octave shift is due to this clause here. The idea is just get creative with patterns. Don't hesitate to play with mod. Don't hesitate to play with that kind of weird stuff. Just see what comes out. Then I wanted to add a fake reverb on top of it as well. So here, the left channel of the signal will be the pattern. The right channel will be the pattern with some delay. And then we also have the pattern repeat with more delay. So if we hear it, it's going to sound like this. So yeah, it gets kind of crazy. Let me play it along with only the pad, and I also added a fake sidechain on top of it, because why not? So yeah, we're getting almost a nostalgic kind of feeling here. Yeah, I think that's about it for today. Let me just play the whole thing for you. Sorry, restart it. So yeah, that's it for today, guys. I hope that that gave you some ideas of stuff you can play with. Next time we will be playing with some percussion to add a basic drum loop to our song. That's it. I will see you next time. Bye.